Well, hello there once again from the Sopka cluster in Krasnoyarsk, Russia, where it's the 29th Winter Universiade. And what entertainment we have had here from the Sopka cluster so far. And it's time for the parallel slalom finals. And after the success of yesterday's parallel giant slalom, the racers are back again. It's a similar start list. But will results be the same, as Russia yesterday were really upset? Well, the schedule of events, the same as yesterday as well. Ladies parallel slalom will lead the way, followed by the men's, where it's a race, red against blue. The racers will take on 24 gates, and then they'll swap over to the other course. The weather conditions, well, it's the cloudiest day that we've experienced here so far, but the snow conditions are near on perfect. The temperature is still strangely warm for Siberia at this time of year. Just 3 weeks ago, it was minus 40. Now it's minus 2. The riders just warming up before they tackle this very, very difficult racing piece, where they'll have to keep rhythm and speed if they want to be successful. Well, the course has a starting altitude of 460 meters, a vertical drop of 130 meters. It's going to be a lot slower than yesterday, but much more technical. The ladies parallel slalom, small final, round one. That means we are racing for a bronze medal. Similar to what's about to happen in the men's events. Republic of Korea up against Russia. Lizaveta Salikova on the blue side. Rim Yong looking focused as well.
Red course ready! Blue course ready!
Looks like we're ready to go. The beep signal, the start of the race, with both racers leaving the starting gate at the same time. Harim Yong on the red course. Looks like she's had a slightly slower start. Elizaveta Salikova on the blue side is gaining some speed, but one thing we know about Harim Yong over the past 2 days is she gets quicker and quicker, but she doesn't need to get quicker now. She needs to stay steady and try and keep the lead in front of Elizaveta Salikova, because this could be all the ingredients of a bronze medal to go with the gold from yesterday. It's only the first run of two, but one mistake from Salikova has meant that Harim Yong is the clubhouse leader in this one. Half a second was the price of that mistake on the upper section. But will it cost the Russian a medal? Russia want to go 1, 2, 3, gold, silver, bronze. Always looking down the hill. Always focusing on the task in hand. Harim Yong is looking like the favorite so far, but there's a long way left in the small final. Big final of the ladies parallel slalom. It's an all-Russian encounter. Milena Bykova, who was second fastest in qualification, is racing against Natalia Sobolova. Sobolova taking bronze yesterday in the parallel giant slalom. Bykova taking silver. Both racers looking for their first gold of these games, and something has to give. One of them will be walking away with gold, one of them with silver, but which one will it be? It's the best of two heats. The gold medal will not be decided as such over this first run, but this run is so crucial in terms of who will be walking away with the gold medal. very, very soon. Bykova has started slightly better, but as the race progresses, Natalia Sobolyeva is riding her way back into this one. There really is nothing between these two. It's going to be an enthralling encounter over these two runs. Sobolyeva or Bykova as they cross the line. So close. Looks as if Milena Bykova takes it. 0.03. And we have another race coming our way very, very soon to decide who's going to win the gold medal. If it's anything like that, we are in for an absolute treat. Bykova snuck it, 0.03. Milena Bykova, after a silver yesterday, going for it today, going for gold. The riders race back to the top. The ladies parallel slalom, small final, run two, medal time. Miriam Yong, gold yesterday in the giant slalom. Currently in bronze medal position with 0.5 seconds over Elizaveta Salikova. Number three bib racing the red course. Both experienced on the World Cup. Long an Olympian as well, but just the 20th in that Olympic game, but it's a clear start and it's a clear advantage for the rider from the Republic of Korea. But on the red gates, Elizaveta Salikova, she means business throughout the opening stage, but there's so long to go. Mistakes could creep in, but who knows what's coming our way. Harim Yong looks as if she's lost a little bit of her time advantage, and the Russians pressing on the red course all the time. We're halfway down. Grip of the way just by a tad again. But the drama's coming our way. Russia and their fans are pushing their rider to the finish line, but she goes over. Two falls in a row. Harim Yong will take the bronze. Gold yesterday, bronze today for the Republic of Korea. What a week for Harim Yong. And what a week for the Republic of Korea. Disappointments for Salikova. She crosses the line. The drama, the excitement that we get from this sport. Unbelievable. But the bronze goes to Yong. Trying to absorb the second half of the turn. Comfortable in the end. Gold and bronze for Harim Yong. The whole day's racing has come down to this. The big final, run two. Natalia Sobolyeva, 0.03 down to Milena Bykova. Natalia Sobolyeva racing on the blue course. And on the red side, Milena Bykova, the second fastest qualifier, silver medalist from yesterday's parallel giant slalom. Natalia Sobolyeva took the bronze yesterday. Something has to give. One of them has to win gold here at the 29th Winter Universiade, and it's neck and neck from the start. You can see there's some nerves in the turns. Sobolyeva has lost some speed. Milena Bykova looks as if she's in control of this one. But there's 34 gates between top and bottom. Lots of room for this lead to change. Natalia Sobolyeva is almost catching up here. She's gaining speed throughout the lower stages. She's coming right back into this one. Milena Bykova, second yesterday, looking for gold today. She's finishing strong, but will she take it? Yes, she will. Sobolyeva 0.5 second behind in the end. Fantastic racing Lena Bykova takes the gold. Natalia Sobolova has to settle for a silver after the bronze of the parallel giant slalom yesterday. Krasnoyarsk is delivering. Half a second. The gold medalist from Russia, Milena Bykova, first place. But it's a Russian 1-2. Natalia Sobolova takes the silver. The men's parallel slalom. Small final, run one for the bronze medal. Dmitry Loganov, who took fourth yesterday, is up against Sang Ho Lee for bronze. Race is going very quickly. Double world champion. Senior and junior level Loganov, but this has not been his games. A fourth yesterday, he would be so, so happy to leave with a medal, but he's up against a stern character in the Korean Sang Ho Lee. Loganov looks like he's just behind, but really, it's so close, as all of these finals have been over the past 2 days here from the Sopka cluster. Russia versus Korea. Russia are looking for a 1-2-3, but Loganov has gone again. Lightning has struck twice, three times over the last 2 days for Loganov. Sang Ho Lee stays consistent, stays in control. And that's the difference between the two riders. Loganov goes for every single turn. He's so aggressive. But that means mistakes creep in. When he's quick, he's quick. But the odd crash comes his way too. Drama. The men's big final. The parallel slalom, gold medal race. Best of two, remember? Russia versus Russia. Dmitry Sarsenbaev medaled yesterday, took a bronze. Dmitry Kalagashev didn't race yesterday. Goggles up for the Russian riding the red course. Slightly flatter light than it was yesterday. Cloudier conditions, but Russia versus Russia is always competitive and it always brings out the best of each riders. Sarsenbaev in blue looks comfortable here. It's a great start for him as well. But Dmitry Kalagashev is going well through the gates. We're only a quarter of the course through, but both Russian riders are giving everything. There's really nothing between them. But as we've seen before, one mistake costs dear, and the mistake comes from Sarsenbaev. Dmitry Kalagashev just has to stay on his feet, just has to stay in control, and he has a clear lead going into the second run. The blue course proving to be problematic for Loganov and Sarsenbaev in the previous two runs. Throwing the ball around. Sarsenbaev, agony for him, but he still has a real chance going in to the second run. The men's parallel slalom, small final, run two.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going for the small final, run number two. Sang Ho Lee versus...
Sang-ho Lee has the advantage over Dmitry Loganov. In your picture. Last preparations for bronze. Sang-ho Lee made the quarterfinals yesterday in the parallel giant slalom. Dmitry Loganov, the double world champion, finished fourth. It's a clear advantage, 1.3 seconds after the fall of Loganov in the first run. So Sang-ho Lee has almost a gate advantage over the Russian, but he's so aggressive, Dmitry Loganov. He goes for broke every single time, and he's almost made up all of that distance on the opening stages of the course. Loganov is going so strong. The local man who's taken world racing by storm. He's gone again. Unbelievable, he's crashed in all four big races over the past 2 days, and Sang-ho Lee takes it. And the Republic of Korea have won both bronze medals here from Krasnoyarsk 2019. And that's the story, Dmitry Loganov. Goes full throttle every single time. And consistency is key to the success of the man in your picture, Sang-ho Lee. The men's parallel slalom, big final for gold. It's an all-Russian race. The tension building. Dmitry Sarsenbaev racing the red course. Dmitry Karlagashev on the blue course in front of him. He has a lead of 1.35 seconds. Dmitry Karlagashev really does have an advantage going into this second run, but he still has to race so well. He knows what threat will be coming from Dmitry Sarsenbaev, who took a medal yesterday. Karlagashev didn't race yesterday at all, but so far it looks as if Sarsenbaev has made some real ground on Dmitry Karlagashev. Remember, 1.35 seconds was the difference, but now there's nothing between the two racers. Sarsenbaev is racing remarkably well here. How has he made up all this time? But can he keep it consistent? No! Once again, he's going for broke. Mistakes creep in. And Dmitry Karlagashev takes the gold. Incredible. Handshakes all round. Went through the gate, Sarsenbaev. And what a performance. Questions asked. Sarsenbaev went direct, and this is the turn that's being looked at. The blue side. Incredible stuff for Dmitry Karlagashev. Russia take gold and silver in both events. The three podium racers that have given everything, not just today, but over the last 2 days, to give spectators ultimate entertainment.
Third place, representing the Republic of Korea, Haring Jung.
The bronze goes to Haring Jung. And after winning gold yesterday, she's done her country so proud. The Republic of Korea take the bronze in the ladies' parallel slalom. It's a great week's work for Hirim Yong. And the fastest in qualifications over the past 2 days, Natalia Sobolova takes the silver today. She's raced hard and she's been incredible throughout the last 2 days. But after a silver yesterday, today is all about Melina Bykova, who is the ladies' parallel slalom winner. Two medals in 2 days, silver yesterday, but gold today. And there, the ladies' parallel slalom podium is confirmed. Russia take gold and silver. The Republic of Korea take bronze. Sang-ho Lee, the Olympic silver medalist, takes bronze today. Consistent throughout, steady. He's done his nation very proud. The Republic of Korea take bronze. A battler, a competitor. Dmitry Sarsenbaev takes the silver from the Siberian State University. But first today goes to Dmitry Karligashev, also from the Siberian State University of Physical Education and Sports. He didn't race yesterday. He saved his best for the parallel slalom today, and he's the gold medalist. Can be so proud of his racing. Smiles all round. Russia take gold and silver. The Republic of Korea take bronze.